Check, YouTube, what's going on? It's Drew here, back at it with another video. And today's video is super freaking special. I am getting my very first hand tattoo, and I'm getting it by the very own Quinn Hernandez. He's the guy that actually did this gothic architecture on the middle of my arm. And it literally still looks like it was put on yesterday. Like, it looks so fresh, but it's actually 2 years old. So I have a lot of confidence in him. I'm just super stoked. It's freaking 7 in the morning, and I've never felt like so energetic and ready to get this thing. I love tattoos, and I want to collect so many more, but I've been waiting so long to get this hand, and I had an opportunity to get it today, and I had to take it. So let's get it. Oh, I should probably tell you the tattoo I'm getting, right? Should I tell you? You know what, if I hit these notes perfectly, I'll tell you. Put your bets on me. Let's go. There's nothing wrong with me loving you. All right, it's a rose. I'm getting a rose. I will be honest, I've never gotten a hand tattoo. This is my first hand tattoo, and I'm a little bit nervous on the pain because I always forget how painful tattoos are until I'm getting them. Especially this level of work is so detailed, so it takes a long time to pack the ink in, and I don't have a lot of beef on my hands. I have quite skinny hands. I'm about to do something crazy. So now for the most important step. I'm 5 minutes out from Quinn's house. Two breakfast burritos, and these Johns are piping hot. Now this is an important step because you got to get some food in your body. No, literally though, the last time I got tattooed and I had no food in my body, I was this fucking close to passing out because I went and I literally did not eat anything before or during. And I remember sitting there and it was like a couple of hours in and like my eyes started going like flashing. I was like, hey, we need to stop for a second. I got to get some food in my body. So I learned that lesson the hard way, but learn from my mistakes. I'm so excited, y'all. I don't even think you understand. For me, and I'm sure if you've been following me for a little bit, you know that I don't see tattoos as just ink on skin. I find artists that their work moves me, that I'm passionate about, and it's an honor to wear a piece from someone like this. When I first saw Quinn's work, I thought it was fake. Like, if I saw his work on like a canvas with pencil or a paintbrush or something, I'd be like, whoa, like how is this possible to make it this realistic? But then he's using ink and a needle to create this beautiful work. I love it. But it's gonna feel so satisfying to complete the sleeve off with the hand. I'm super stoked and just grateful. All right, we just made it in the studio. This place is sick. You already know my boy got the magazine cover. Okay, let him know, Quinn, let him know. All right, we're taking a little break right now, but we're probably about 45 minutes in. And the thing that's crazy about these realism tattoos is you don't really see it come together until the end, and then all of a sudden it's like this beautiful piece. So here's where we're at right now. Getting there. It's about to get crazy. How you feeling, Quinn?
Well, feeling good.
Feeling good?
Feeling good.
Good, man. We just got the white left. We're almost finished. We've been chopping it out. So this is definitely the most painful part. For those of you who haven't gotten tattoos before, usually you save the white for the end. It's the highlights. And why do you think it hurts so much? Because it's like you've already gone over it.
Yeah, your body's checking out, man. It's done.
Yeah.
It's over it. You don't want no more. And you gotta go back where the whole thing was white. Ugh. But it's not the ink. It's not the needle. It's not the machine.
Yeah.
It's just your look. I mean, it's not red right now because I used that ointment on there, but mm-hmm. your hand's just done.
Yeah, it is. It feels
and
cooked.
Then you go back and go, yeah.
It feels cooked.
They were all me.
Wish me luck. Okay, so the next clip you're gonna see is the final product. Get ready, get your popcorn out. It's about to get crazy. The only thing is, I apologize, I took it on my phone, so it's a vertical video. Please don't hate me. All right, here you go. Bye. I look good today. my boy Quinn just hooked it up. We are all set. It's been a long day.
Long day.
And I'm ready to get back, and I'm ready to get this bad boy healed up. So, Quinn, thank you for everything, bro.
Appreciate it, man.
Thank you for everything.
Hell yeah.
And we'll reunite here in a little bit before we know it.
Cool, bro.
All right, brother.
Thank
you so much.
Be careful, bro.
Appreciate it. Okay, we finally made it home. 4-hour drive. I'm absolutely starving, and I'm exhausted. I had to be up at 6 in the morning this morning. Sorry about my depression room, by the way. But we got her. It was sore on the way back, I'll be honest. But the thing that's cool about this type of healing, Saniderm, is that all you do is just leave it on and it heals itself. It's breathable, but it also protects the tattoo as well, which is really important on somewhere like your hand. I do have an extra slip, so I can take this off if it starts to fall off and put another one on. But yeah, obviously it's really hard to see underneath this wrapping, and with the lighting, it's not very good. As the tattoo heals, it will start to lighten to match the rest of my sleeve. With black and gray tattoos, it is dark initially, but then once it settles in, these light, subtle, beautiful grays come out. So shout out to Quinn, my favorite artist. I admire that guy so much. I consider him a friend of mine, and I'm so grateful that he blessed me with this piece for the rest of my life. Okay, that's all. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Peace.